Well, good is, again, philosophically, it would be the most general values that are positive with respect to human life. So one way of thinking about the good is in a more biological sense, because humans are complicated, so often it's easier to start with other animals. So you say, suppose you're talking about a bird. What is good for a bird? And you say, well, a bird, if it is going to survive, it has certain nutritional needs. It needs proteins and various other things. So anything that is in the bird's environment that is a source of protein for it would be good for the bird. But we also know that the bird needs to take actions in order to hunt the protein source that it needs. So it has eyes, and so you would say the bird having eyes that work and that work well, that is good for the bird. The bird has feathers and wings. The bird has to fly in order to get to its prey. So it's good for the bird to be able to fly, to keep its feathers clean and in good condition, so that it can do the kinds of actions that will enable it to get the food that it needs, and so on. So in that basic sense, we would say the good are those things in the world that enable you to stay alive, and also the good is your core capacities that you can exercise that will enable you to act in the world to get the good things out there in the world. So in the case of human beings, we would tell then a more complicated story. We would say, like other animals, we have nutritional needs. So some things in the world are a source of nutrition for us. Those are all good for us. And we contrast things that have no nutritional value for us, they are neutral. But on things that are poisons or toxic for us, those are bad for us. And then we would, just if we stick with the example of food, to keep it simple, we would say things that enable us to act in the world. Hunting, farming, the performance of agriculture, doing science to discover new food sources, doing engineering to develop machines that can enable us more productively to get food in the environment. All of those capacities are also good for human beings. And then to get even more broader, because human beings are more complicated, we typically start to do these in social situations with divisions of labor, and so economics becomes important. And so we have to identify good economic arrangements that enable us, again, just to keep the example simple with respect to food, to be productive with respect to food, political arrangements, the same sort of thing.